Okay, so let's see more the examples of the sequence. So one thing you have to remember, right? To find the limit of the terms r to the n. Okay, so this term, right? You know that this is if the term r, right, is absolute r, right, less than 1. That means that, right, the term r is between negative 1 and 1. Okay, so the limit r to the n, right, is also equal to 0, right? And if the term r equal 1, right, so then the limit is also equal 1. But if the term r is greater than 1, okay, so this is equal to positive infinity. Okay, that means that, right, is also does not exist, right? So be careful, right, to find the value of the limit. Okay. Then, okay, so let's see examples. We have to check. Just start with the easier one. Okay. The sequence an equals the run n, right? Over n plus 1. Okay. So to check whether the sequence is converged or divergent, right? We just find the limit of the term an when n approaches to positive infinity, right? Or n close to positive infinity. This term is the limit of the term run n over n plus 1. And then from the graph of the natural log, right, when n close to positive infinity, right, the limit of the run n also close to positive infinity, right? So this is the infinite by the infinite. Okay, then we have to use the L'Hopital rule. We have to chain, right? Change the term, the function, to continue as, right, just use this. And then this is in the, then we can ask from the L'Hopital rules, right? The limit is also equal the derivative, right, of the top term, right, divided by which equal. So this is equal 0, right? Then x goes to positive infinity. Okay. Then so that means that, right? Then the limit of the term n initial back is also 0, which is the real number, right? So we can conclude that our sequence, right, is also converged, right? Okay. So just check, right, whether the limit and is close to positive infinity or not. Okay, then let's see more examples. Okay. We have to use more techniques. If the term, right, an equals sine of 2n, right, over 1 plus square root n. Let's see more. From this term, right, you know that, right, the value of the term sine is between half the amplitude, right, equal 1, right? That means, right, the value of the sine is half the value, right, greater than or equal negative 1, right, and less than equal 1. And since 1 plus square root n is a positive term, we can divide by this, not change, right, the inequality sign. And after that, we take the limit, right? And then after that, right, we take the limit that n cross 2 positive infinity. So we found that, right, the limit of negative 1, right, over 1 plus, this is also equals 0, right? And also the limit of the 1 over square root n is also 0, okay? Then we can conclude that, right, by squeeze theorem, right? We can answer it. By squeeze theorem, right, we can answer, right? That means that our sequence is also converged, right? Okay. Our sequence is also converged. Okay. So just use the, this is also use the techniques of the squeeze theorem, right? You also have the L'Hopital's squeeze theorem, right? And what else? Okay. So next, right, we also have to check whether our sequence has the monotonic or not, right? And it's about bounded or not. Okay, so let's see. We define, right? This is from in your head, alright? It's Bn, right? Equals n times with the exponential of to the n. Okay. So, I think if you cannot see, right, more pictures of this, right? Just write the sequence. If n equal 1, right? So, we got that. And if n equal 2. If n equal 3. Sorry. Equal 3 and so on, right, until the term we have to find. Okay, so first we can find the this limit is the converse order, right? So we find the limit of this term is equal n to the e to the. This is still in the indeterminate form, right? In infinite to infinite, right? If you compare to the graph of the exponential, right? If then we have to use the L'Hopital's rules, right? So we have to change in the term of the continuous function, right? Then we can find this is in the indeterminate form. We can use, right, so by L'Hopital rules. Then the functions, right, limit of the function f over g, right, is equal, right, the derivative, right, of the top term, right, and then divide, which is also equal 0. So this is x's, right, then this, the first we also know, right? This sequence is also converged. Okay, so now we have to find, we have to compare, right? So check if the increasing or decreasing. We have to compare with the term, Bn plus 1, right, and the term Bn. Okay, One thing we know that, right? The term n less than the term n plus 1, right? And exponential term is the increasing function, right? So the term e to the n, right? Also less than e to the n plus 1. Anyways, I think it's easier, right? Just check this by phi. Or we can find, right? The and if you would like to find, or we can find, right? The term be n plus 1 minus b n. Or the other term, or we can find, right? If this equals. And then, or we find the derivative, right? Is the less than or easier, right? So this is the, okay, this is easier, right? If we find, right, the derivative, this term, right? So you've got that, the product rule, right? So which equals, so when we find if the term x is greater than 1, right? So you found that this is the less than. So if x greater than 1, right? If x greater than 1, so this is the less than 0, right? Then this is the decreasing, right? So then this term is less than 0, right? So you got it, right? So f is the decreasing. So one thing you can find from the derivative, right? If you would like to find from the difference, right, between b n and b n. Okay, so if we find this, we've got that. So just choose right one method to find. And this is also equals n plus 1 term. Okay, and then we take, right, simplify the terms. This, right, this term also equals n over e times. And then plus 1, right? And then this term is the minus. Okay, then this term we can take the, right, so this term is equal, and the last term is, okay, then this is the, negative, right, this is the positive, now, then we compare. So if this term, we also found that the term bn plus 1, right, is this is the also less than the term bn. Okay, so same. Then we found that this is also the decreasing, right? This is also the decreasing sequence. Okay, so if we check like this, right, so it have to, but I think that five from the derivative is easier, okay. So if this is the decreasing, then we can conclude that this also that the monotonic, right, sequence, okay. And to check whether the value of the bn is the, have the bounded or not, right? So we have to compare the term. Okay, so we have a graph of the exponentials, right?
This is.
And then when we file this term, right? The value of the term, if we compare, right? The exponential also greater than. N, right? When. So this term is also less than 1, right? When we divide. This is also less than 1. So 1, this means that is the bounded above. Okay. And this is always the first term is the 1 over E, which is the greater than 0. Okay. So this is the bounded below. So then from this we can conclude that our sequence Bn is also that is a also bounded sequence. Okay. That's the examples, right? Have the techniques to find the limits, and then you also have that the example, right? To find the monotonics. Okay. So don't forget that. That we conclude right from the last EP that the increasing, decreasing, non-decreasing, non-increasing also monotonics, right? And bounded above and bounded below, right? Also bounded. Okay. Okay. So let's see next EP. Bye.